2020 Solon City Council meeting to order. We'll start with the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America
and to the republic for which it stands,
one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Present.
Mr. Katara?
Here.
Mrs. Meany?
Here.
Mr. Palunas?
Here.
Mr. Russo?
Here.
Mr. Schmitz?
Here.
Mr. Zellin?
Here.
Okay, changes to the agenda. We are moving under Planning Commission Consent Item Number 3 to Planning Commission, and that'll be Item Number 1. And then Item Number 1 on Planning Commission Consent will be Item 2. Item 2 will be Item 3. Okay, announcements are as published, and we are always excited when we can have an oath of office for our finest in blue. So I guess, Mayor, I will let you take over.
Can you hear me? Okay. So it's always a pleasure for me. One of my greatest pleasures is the promotion of an individual in our police department. Chief Tinelli, it's about a year now. He has a magic touch. And the magic touch is to take what is already the finest police department in Northeastern Ohio, and I can attest to that. We're very blessed here because not only do we get the very best in law enforcement, we can recruit, unlike many other communities, we can recruit the very best, but what we do in Solon, which is somewhat unique, we're able to keep them, we train them, we educate them, we grow them, and we rise people up through the ranks. And it's very unique to be able to do that as a community, and that's why we have the finest police department and the finest law enforcement agency in Northeastern Ohio. Individual tonight, Roy Cunningham, I hope many of you know Roy and have met Roy. One of the things that also we're blessed, not just having the best talent, but also we have a community, probably over 90%, I would say 90, 95% of our residents support our police department. And there's a reason for that. And one of the reasons, particularly tonight, is about someone by the name of Roy Cunningham. If you've noticed over the years, and I was on council for many years, and all the information that goes out to our residents daily, the public information that our residents see, it could be something small or it could be something large. But all of that information that get out to the public, that's why our residents support our police officers. That's why our residents support the blue. That's why our businesses all support the police department, because we have a seamless relationship with our residents and with our businesses. It's called community policing. A lot of that information, that public information over many, many years that's been disseminated and it's given us that ability to have that community support is because of Roy Cunningham, because Roy took the time and effort to make sure that all that information was disseminated to the public, discussed with the public, so the people had a true understanding of what our police department is all about. So, Chief, once again, you have that great touch of promoting the very best that we have in our community, and it's an honor for me tonight to be able to promote Roy to lieutenant. We've had some significant promotions over the last year, and this one of Roy becoming a lieutenant just adds to that. So it's a great honor and privilege, and Roy, why don't you come on up? Okay, let's do it. Raise your right hand. I, Roy Cunningham, do solemnly swear that I will support the Constitution and laws of the United States. The Constitution and laws of the State of Ohio. The Charter and ordinances of the City of Solon. And that I will faithfully, honestly, and impartially Discharge my duties.
Discharge my duties.
As a lieutenant.
As a lieutenant.
For the Solon, Ohio Police Department.
For the Solon, Ohio Police Department.
To the best of my knowledge and ability.
To the best of my knowledge and ability.
During my term and continuance.
During my term and continuance.
In said office.
In said office.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations. I'm just going to embarrass you.
I have a much smaller family gathering this time because of the pandemic. My wife, Tina, and my daughter, Jessica, are here. And without them, I never would have even been able to become a police officer. They've given me support in my career change when I decided to become a police officer. I also have some friends here. I have Ryan, a friend of mine since we were 14 or 15 years old. He's one of those people you generally only have one or two of those friends in your whole life. And his wife Michelle in the back there, and my friend Donovan Paquette in the back. He's a police officer in Mayfield, and we went to the academy together. So we've been through quite a bit together over the years and kind of supported each other. I want to thank all the officers of the Solon Police Department. I want to thank the mayor, city council, the chief, and all the officers who have helped me along the way. Really, you can't accomplish anything on your own, and everyone in this room wearing a uniform has taught me something. I've learned from even people that I've helped train during the FTO process, and I wouldn't be standing up here today if it weren't for all of you. So it's a group accomplishment. I'm up front, but it's everybody that supported me along the way. So thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thanks everyone for coming. Really appreciate it, especially the men and women of our police department, and I'm sure Chief Tonelli has a cake out there somewhere. Or maybe he's hiding it.
Okay, we'll give you guys a few minutes. I didn't know if anybody wanted to take pictures real quick.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, absolutely.
Take a few pictures and. Hey, Chief, how are you?
Hey, Chief.
Do you want us to get out of the way?
This is a photo bomb.
I think we'll be covered pretty well.
Yeah, I think so too.
And do you still want me to read? No, I don't think it's necessary.
Take care.
I would just say the address.
Right.
But I think you have to say it's going to be tabled.
What's that?
I think you have to say it's going to be tabled. That's not me. Okay.
So do you want to read it or no? I'll read it.
Just read the address.
Stuff out someday. Okay.
The masks just ruin everything.
Hmm?
The masks just ruins it all.
I know. Okay, congratulations. Congratulations. Okay. Thanks, everybody, for coming.
Good night, Chief. All right.
You're out of here.
Maybe we'll save some cake for the chief.
Yeah. Okay, I think we have everybody out of here. Okay, moving on. We have a special guest tonight. I'm very happy that this gentleman took the time out to come. We have a new representative from First Energy. His name is Dean Hain, and he is with us this evening. So, Mr. Hain, if you'd like to come up, introduce yourself. We're very happy to have you. If you want to go right, yeah. Okay.
Thank you. Everybody hear me okay?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you. Well, I appreciate the opportunity to come up and say hello tonight, introduce myself. Again, Dean Hain, some of you have had the opportunity to meet already virtually, some emails back and forth. I appreciate all the correspondence. But I wanted to formally introduce myself tonight. Again, Dean Hain, First Energy, your external affairs representative, formerly known as area manager. I think my predecessor, David Conley, you well know. David Dillon is pretty famous in this area, I believe. So I hope to do a good job just as they did. Myself, a little bit of history as far as the company. I've been with the company, I hate to say this, but start dating myself, a little over 30 years. Started delivering mail on a part-time basis many years ago. Went to college, and, you know, next thing you know, you're like, how'd I get here? But I'm very happy. The company's been very good to me. I'm grateful for the opportunity to come out here and work with the cities, municipalities, and so on. Prior to this position, I was with Ohio Edison. They call customer support. You deal mostly with commercial industrial customers. I had schools down there as well. A little bit of interaction with the cities. Prior to that, First Energy called it project management from a compliance perspective with independent generators, solar generators, gas generators, all those folks going online. So prior to that, several different positions in customer service, a lot of them dealing with interface between our IT departments and our different vendors that have to do with customer service products, billing, payment, et cetera, how our system works, all kind of focused around helping to enhance the customer experience throughout my career. So I hope to continue that and do well by you folks and help you as well. Currently, my wife and I, Melissa, live down in Stowe, looking to relocate. It's time for a change. She works with the company as well, my better half, needless to say. Our son Nathan is 16. He goes to St. Vincent, St. Mary in Akron. It's his second year there. Likes it, doing well. Originally from Western Pennsylvania area. I call this home now, Northeast Ohio. It's always back home, but this is home. I think that's about it. Again, your liaison, any questions, I may regret this someday, but any time of day, any questions you have, any needs you have, please feel free to call me. I'll leave some cards at the end. If anybody has any questions you want to ask, we can do it then. Anything as of right now?
Okay. Anybody have any questions? Anybody? Jeremy?
Yeah, no. So, Mr. Cunningham, it's Councilman Zellwin. I've got Ward 3. We've had lots of utility and power outages this year, I'm sure, like other cities in the area. I know that Mr. Dursick and Mr. Bush have been working with you and
yes,
and communicating with you on those issues. So anything you could do to help remediate those. I know some of them are due to down trees, but then other times I'm getting calls from residents on sunny days where they don't have power. And it seems like I've got more calls this year than the previous 3 years combined. So just want to put that on the record.
Yeah, appreciate that. Sorry to hear that. But yeah, I have been in touch with those folks and continue to work together to improve that service, get to the bottom of
yep.
it. Improve
it. Much appreciated.
Thank you. I apologize. I'm not sure where the camera's at.
No, yeah, no. It's, and it's good to meet you virtually. Sorry, we're not there in person.
It's right above the solar sign.
Anyone else?
Okay. I mean, I would just echo Jeremy. I think all of us, unfortunately, you know, whether it's just the crazy storms we had over the summer, and I know you and I have communicated. I did have a question about smart meters, because I know they've been being installed throughout the city, correct?
Correct, okay. Yeah. Okay. I believe that's been going on for maybe a year, a little over a year.
Right. Yeah, I know mine was done maybe 2 months ago. Do you have a date of when you think that project is going to be complete? I know I had some residents that you had to come back out and replace their lines. I mean, it's another, some questions I've gotten from residents in regards to the smart meters. Do you have any idea when you think that project will be complete?
I can go back and check on that. From what I've heard, is we're going to be still working on it through early next year.
Okay.
Now, does that mean January? Does that mean March? I'll have to further see what I can find out for you on that.
Okay. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. Anybody else have any questions? More questions?
I do.
Mark? Mr. Storer?
Hi, Mr. Hain. You and I have one of the people that we've corresponded with via email a couple of times. Thank you. It's nice to meet you in person. Like Councilman Zellwin, I too have been getting a lot of phone calls about some power outages and such. And some of those have also happened on sunny days, but there have been issues with trees. So that brings me to I guess my question, are we able to get some more forest management along the utility right-of-ways and certain developments? It seems like, I know I've had residents calling and saying that they felt branches were close, and ultimately some of those did cause some power outages several months down the road.
Mm-hmm.
I know there's a schedule, but perhaps maybe Mother Nature's schedule isn't in sync with First Energy, so maybe we could get some of that evaluated. Would that be a possibility?
I'd be happy to look into that for you. Okay. If you have any specific areas that you could direct me towards or point towards.
I do, and I will put them in an email to you.
Okay, be happy to look into that for you.
Thank you.
Okay, Mr. Shimmis has a question for you.
Oh, welcome, Mr. Hain.
Thank you.
I've been basically putting out all the fires on social media every time the power goes out, and there's always somebody that knows a heck of a lot more than I do. And one of the things they've been asking for is kind of like a report from like maybe the last 2 years on items that were not tree related, that were not, you know, car accident or not something like that. You know, what were the problems that created the outages? Is there a way of getting some kind of a report similar to that or with that kind of information?
I'm not saying there isn't. I'll have to check into that for you. The one thing we run into a lot of times is there can be so much information. The way outages are recorded in one particular circuit, we could have essentially tens, if not hundreds, of outages the way they're reported. So it's sometimes the way reporting comes together, it may overinflate or paint a different picture than what you would think.
I mean, obviously Solon related.
But it still gets pretty big. Yeah. There's probably a lot more than
I'm
you
sure.
think of. But I will look into that to see what we might be able to provide. They're usually the basics as far as tree, carpool accidents. But I can look into see if we have anything from a higher level that kind of pulls it together for you.
I'd appreciate that.
Anybody else have any other questions? Okay.
Okay, thank you very much.
Great.
Look forward
thank
to working with
you so much
everyone.
For coming. We really appreciate it. We look forward to working with you.
Likewise, thank you.
Okay, bye-bye. Okay, moving on then, comments from the audience regarding agenda items. Do we have anyone on the line, Jim?
There's no callers at this time, but I did want to make you aware that I believe the gentleman from the local press was on the line for quite a while. Probably because that YouTube Lives was down.
Okay.
But that is back up now.
Oh, it is. Okay.
Yes. And as I said before, we are still going over the PSA channel, and
right.
we'll post this after the fact,
right. okay.
both the previous meeting and this one.
Okay,
once
very
done.
Good.
So, but
okay.
no callers.
Great, thank you. Okay, we have a set of minutes we need to get approved.
I'll make a motion to accept the minutes of September 21st, 2020.
Second.
Okay, I have a motion from Mr. Shimmett, seconded from Mr. Palunas. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mr. Katora?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Shimmets?
Yes.
Mr. Zellwin?
Yes.
Okay, Planning Commission, item number one, I'll do this. This is 6050 Cruzy Drive and 33095 Bainbridge Road, Omni. SLF Solon LLC and Omni Bainbridge Road LLC. In our discussions during caucus, we're going to table this for this evening and get some, unfortunately, the applicant was unable to be here this evening, so I think, you know, there were some questions that we just needed to get answered. So, like I say, this item is going to be tabled for this evening. Moving on then to Planning Commission consent, item number two.
An application was received from 39660 Patterson Lane, permanent parcel numbers 955-20-022 and 955-20-052, Thornberry Homeowners Association, for a lot split and consolidation, and it was approved by the Planning Commission.
Okay, item number three.
An application was received for 5530 Somme Center Road, Marie and Jeffrey McCausland, for a 2-foot fence height variance. This item was approved by the Planning Commission with a 3-2 vote, contingent upon additional landscaping being planted in the spring. The Planning Commission denied a number of accessory structures variance to permit two because the applicant agreed to remove the shed located on the property to comply with the zoning code.
Thank you. Item number four.
An application was received for 33270 Outley Park Drive, Kathleen Bisson, for a 15-foot accessory pavement front yard setback variance, which was approved by the Planning Commission.
Okay, Mr. Bentley.
Yes, I'd like to go ahead and actually, I've got a question about number, what do we call it, number three now.
Okay.
This is the one at 5530. Mr. Franklin, you help me here. I thought that they were going to, well, they just, we just removed the application for this, the second accessory structure. And they were going to use the existing structure.
So no, actually, they were going to tear down the existing structure on the building that caused the variance and keep we are talking to one about the chicken coop, right? The
correct,
coop.
Yes.
Yeah, so they were going to keep the coop and tear down the existing storage building.
All right, okay. All right, so thank you for clearing that up for me. So with that, thank you. I'd like to go ahead and make the motion to pass these items on, please.
Second.
Okay, I have a motion from Mr. Bentley, seconded from Mr. Russo. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mr. Katura?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Paloonis?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Shimmets?
Yes.
Mr. Zellwin?
Yes.
Okay, moving on to pending, we have no items. Moving on to correspondence, item number five.
A proposed amendment to section 1288.043D, entitled Non-Commercial Opinion Signs of the Zoning Code. This item was referred to the Planning Commission on 9-8. There is no new material.
Okay, we discussed this in caucus, and there is no new material on this issue. Okay, moving on to new, item number six.
Ordinance number 2020-167, amending section 248.02, entitled Duties of City Engineer, Appointment, Qualifications, and Section 249.02, Construction Project Administrator of the Administration Code. And we're leaving this on first reading?
Correct. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Okay, moving on to the consent portion of our agenda, item number seven.
Ordinance number 2020-168, adopting the annual appropriations for personal services and other expenditures of the City of Solon for the period January 1st, 2020, to December 31st, 2020, and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Zellwin.
Yes, this item has to do with the city got another allocation from the CARES Act, this time in the amount of $927,410.80 that was allocated from the state to the city. It's the balance of the $650 million allocation to the state of Ohio, and this is aiding that to the Fund 271.
Thank you very much. Item number eight.
Ordinance number 2020-169, accepting the proposal of Regency Construction Services for the architectural design and construction services to renovate Fire Station Number 1 dormitory space through the Sourcewell Cooperative Purchasing Program and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Russo.
Sure. This is being done, and this was approved earlier at our special safety meeting, and this is being done due to the current COVID-19 pandemic and potential spread of the virus through open space. This will be in the amount of $502,438.20, and the funds for the cost of this expenditure will be taken from the Solon Coronavirus Relief Fund. And this is under emergency.
Great. Thank you very much.
Shadow man.
Okay. I'll entertain a motion then. And I'll jump at once.
I'll make a motion to approve the consent agenda under suspension, please.
Second.
Okay. I get a motion from Mr. Katoris, seconded for Mr. Palunas. Roll call under suspension.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mr. Katora?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Shimmets?
Yes.
Mr. Zellin?
Yes.
Final passage.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mr. Katora?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Shimmets?
Yes.
Mr. Zellin?
Yes.
Okay, moving on. Comments from the audience. You have anybody on, Mr. Gibbs?
Nobody at this time.
Okay, thank you. Okay, moving then. Comments from council. Mr. Bentley.
Yes, hi. I've got a comment. There was an incident that happened here in Solon where the police was called an individual for loading groceries into his car recently, and it's kind of disturbing to me, and I've talked to several residents who were disturbing to them. I know there are meetings scheduled with the powers to be here in Solon to kind of drill down on what exactly happened and how we proceed with these kinds of events going forward. And I felt it was important that I mention that it did happen here in Solon. You read about it all over the country, but it's the first time it's happened here in Solon, and we are taking a look at it and going to come to an agreement to understand that happens, and so all parties involved can understand what happens, what the ramifications are. Other than that, that's it for me. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Zellin.
Yes. So, want to congratulate Lieutenant Cunningham on his promotion today. Also, welcome the kids back to school. I know that my children were happy to be back in the classroom this morning versus online learning. So those families that opted for the in classroom, welcome back to school. Also want to remind everyone in Solon, if you want to keep our children back in school, continue to follow the protocols that are at hand, and make sure you wear a mask, social distance. Also, tomorrow is the first day of you can vote at the Board of Elections. So make sure that you vote this election season. And if anyone needs a ride to the polls on election day, please reach out to me. I'm happy to help take you to the polls that day. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Russo.
Sure. First of all, I'd like to congratulate Lieutenant Cunningham on his promotion. Secondly, carrying on with what Jeremy said, I'd encourage people to get out and vote. There's no excuse not to. You're only disenfranchising yourself if you do not vote. If you do not feel comfortable going to the polls, especially now, you should get your application to receive an absentee ballot. I believe Ohio does the best job of providing non-in-person voting by requiring every resident that would request a ballot to make that request. It does get verified to make sure that you are a registered voter, and then your vote will be counted. Secondly, also would like to ask Chief Tinelli if they could make sure that we could do selective enforcement around the schools, now, especially now that schools are actually back in session in person, especially around the ABC streets and around Roxbury. That would be appreciated. And then finally, I know this has been completed, but the last couple of weeks we've had police from a number of different departments participating at the shooting range. It's something, it's training that needs to be done. But I did have a number of residents calling or emailing, wondering what's been going on. And according to Chief Tinelli, this happens every 2 to 3 years. And it's an extended period of time. And I think just because of the fact that people were home due to the pandemic, People were aware this was going on, where in the past people were at work and this was not a nuisance to them. But again, this is training that needs to be done. And I think the residents do understand that, but they were just trying to get an idea of what was all the shooting for. So those are my comments this evening.
Thank you. Mr. Petora.
I too would like to congratulate Lieutenant Cunningham on his promotion. And I'd like to add that I was very impressed with his comments at the end of his oath. And I was very proud of him too for those comments. He was appreciative of everybody he's worked for, and it's obvious he takes his job very seriously. So I'm proud of him for that. I'd like to also thank the mayor for attending the retirement party of the pastor at the Solon Community Church, which is in my ward. It's also the church that I grew up going to and was a past member of the Board of Trustees. And Mayor, thanks for, especially during a Brown Sunday, coming out and presenting that wonderful proclamation. I know that it was very much appreciated by me as well as all the other members of the church. And those are my comments for the evening.
Mr. Schimmitz. Oh.
I would also like to congratulate Lieutenant Cunningham. It's always really, really great to see the promotions being done from inside in-house. And it's also very nice to see the support that he had here this evening. A lot of the officers showed up. It's always good to see that. That means you're doing something right. Mm-hmm. Also, I believe this Saturday is the Fall Fest. Was it 10 to 4? So over at the community park. So hopefully a lot of people will be out there. I think for the first time ever, the Slimans truck will be there. So Ooh. Let's go, corned beef.
That's thanks, all. Bob. Thanks. Mr. Palunas.
I'd like to congratulate the officer and the Solon Police Department on the promotion this evening. And that's all I have.
Okay. I also want to, say kudos and congrats to Lieutenant Cunningham. He's just a wonderful police officer and has really done so much for Solon and a well-deserved promotion. This evening we did, one of the items that we did was the CARES Act and the money that finally cities are starting to get. So I really do want to give a shout out, and this is no politics, but I just want to give a shout out to our state rep, Phil Robinson, and our state senator, Matt Dolan, who really worked very hard for the city of Solon, and I really appreciate all of their efforts in getting this money to us. This has been, tough times and, spending money on things that I don't think we ever thought in our lives we'd have to be spending money on. So this is very, very much appreciated by the city. And thanks to both of these gentlemen for, like I say, all of their hard work for Solon. I also just want to give a shout out to my parish, Church of the Resurrection. They had a prayer, blue prayer day. We call it a blue mass. But for our safety forces, this was this past Friday. It was very nicely attended and I think was appreciated by our safety forces. And we were very blessed to have such fine ladies and gentlemen on our forces. And I think it showed them too, because there were a number of parishioners who came also, how important they are to our community and that they are in our prayers. And I believe those are my comments. And so we'll move to comments from the administration, starting with the mayor. I'll cut you off if you go too long.
I know. So, Mark, it was a wonderful afternoon. Beatrice Woods, Reverend Dr. Beatrice Woods is a remarkable lady with a remarkable record. I commented yesterday all the interfaith programs that we have in Solon, and it's truly amazing. And she gave just great inspiration to so many of those programs and healing and everything she does for the community. So it was an honor and a privilege, and I think the Browns brought us good luck during that. So it was great to hang out with you, and to my dear friends at Resurrection. That was a lovely afternoon program to honor the men and women of our safety forces. City Hall is open. It's open just for the last few days, and it's gone well, and we're taking all the precautions. Nancy, great comments. Rep Phil, Senator Matt have just been tremendous for the community. They continue to really hone in on Solon and making sure we get what we need and our voices are heard in Columbus. I would echo everyone's comments about voting. Make sure you get out there, vote, do it in person or mail-in. I think today was the last day to register, I believe. So the time is now to get out and vote. Thank you for all your comments about Roy Cunningham. He is just a treasure in the community, and it was just a great promotion into a wonderful leadership position. I want to recognize Director Shaker. As you're probably well aware, Angie came here 2 years ago, and she came from an educational background, many years at Cleveland Heights City School Districts. She went to the Cleveland Municipal School District for several years, and she really delved into, over the last couple of years, economic development, and so much so that I'm honored to say that she received her Ohio CED certification. Best in class for this certification with the Ohio Economic Development Institute. She has worked tirelessly over the last 2 years to get this certification, and she's working with all of the great economic development authorities throughout the state of Ohio. So I'm just so proud of her for all the work and the effort and the perseverance that it took her. I mean, she had to write papers on the weekends and at night after staying here, you know, long hours to make sure that she got this certification. And her perseverance in doing this is a great testament to the leader she is in economic development. And now she's looked up to by her peers in that regard. So congrats, Angie. Job well done.
All right, Angie.
I don't know how many corned beef sandwiches you're going to eat on Saturday, but we could have a contest. There's always a way to have a contest with Shimmitz. But yes, we'll see everyone if you could make it to the fall market. I think 10 to 4 on Saturday. Obviously, we're going to be asking people for social distancing and masks, but very excited to have this fall market. I had an opportunity to last week go to the Senior Center retreat, their staff. It was really a fun afternoon. And as good as the Senior Center staff is when you see them on the outside, it's truly amazing how they come together on the inside and how supportive they are each other, how much they work together, and makes you realize, you know, what a wonderful senior staff and a senior community that we have. I was running this morning early, and I saw the lineup at Lewis School as the cars were pulling in. So the kids are back in school. I don't think all of the kids, some of the kids are still going virtual, but welcome the kids back in school. And just lastly, Mackie, I appreciate the comments. Obviously, when someone makes a call, you never know what their spirit is and what their heart is. And sometimes you can't control what someone does, but what we can do here, we can make sure that our police officers respond in a professional way. And I want to thank our police officers. They did respond, and they always do the same thing when they respond to these situations, as they de-escalate these situations. So I want to thank the response, our police officers, and I believe Chief Tonelli has spoken to this. He's written communications to the folks involved. So I want to thank our police department for the response that they gave to what a situation that could have escalated. What they did, because of their training that they do at our police department, they was able to de-escalate a situation, and those are my comments tonight. Thank you.
Great. Thank you. Mr. Lobey.
No comments tonight.
Mr. Laterna.
No comments.
Mr. Shaker. Congratulations, Angie.
Thank you, Vice Mayor Meany. I appreciate it. And thank you, Mayor Krause, for the very kind comments. Much appreciated. Just a quick comment, if you haven't seen it yet, Solon was featured in the October issue of Cleveland Magazine. We've got a local family on the cover. Also highlighted our faces of safety, Chief Vetter and Chief Tonelli. They look great. So definitely read this. There's some community and economic development projects talked about near our schools. Definitely worth picking up and reading if you can. That's it.
Great, thank you. Mr. Bush?
Nothing tonight, thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Franklin?
Nothing, thank you.
Okay. Chief Vetter?
Yes, thank you. Congratulations, Angie, and congratulations, Lieutenant Cunningham. Just a quick update. Thank you for everyone's patience as we completed flushing and testing about 2,090 fire hydrants that we touched in the month of September. That's always important to make sure that those are in good repair, and especially that they're draining before the winter months and freezing. In October, we now start into another aggressive project of doing hose testing, and we'll be testing about 19,000 feet of fire hose during the month of October. I'm pleased to report that we advertised our firefighter paramedic entrance exam to establish a list for eligibility. We topped that at 100 applicants, and we filled that pretty quickly. And I'm also pleased to report that this was the first time that we've completed online applications and online fee processing, and that worked out quite well. And thanks to the IT department for their assistance in getting all that set up, as well as human resources and the Civil Service Commission. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Holly.
Good evening. Congratulations, Angie, and to Lieutenant Cunningham. I do have a few updates for the service department. September marked the end of two new programs that we had started. We had our dumpster drop program, which took place at the truck drops, traditionally that we would drop at residents' house. That both programs ran from end of May to end of September, and there was 159 total drops, dumpsters that were dropped, which was outstanding. It was a huge success for us and the residents. That equated to 137 total tons of debris that was not picked up curbside, which helped our crews progress along the route. So looking forward to another good year next year. The other program that concluded was our Saturday drop program, which was kind of born out of the whole COVID pandemic. It was another avenue for residents who could not come down during the week, especially during our shutdown time. So we had 6 days of drop-offs. During the Saturday drop program, there was 968 residents that took use of that program. HHW, cardboard, construction debris, and other materials like that were brought down. Again, not on the curb, which helps out our crews to be more efficient during the route. So we're looking forward to another year with that next year and improving, you know, how we can make that program a little bit better. It is that time of the season, so October 19th we'll start our leaf season program. You may see some of our units out the week prior, October 12th. We're going to do a soft start, have all the units out and run them through the routes, make sure that they're operating at full capacity and everything to go for the 19th. So other than that, that's all the comments I have tonight.
Great. Thanks, Mark. Okay, Mr. Rubino.
Nothing tonight. Thank you.
Thank you. Chief Tonelli.
Thank you. First, congratulations again to Lieutenant Cunningham for his well-deserved promotion to the rank of lieutenant, and to Angie for her great accomplishment. And just to touch on some school issues that was brought up by Mr. Russo, now that school is in session, the police department is basically doing three different things for police presence. One is selective enforcement, special attention for the school zones for speeders. We continue to have two officers assigned to the schools full-time every day that school is in session. And we continue to encourage patrol officers to walk through the schools in between their calls. So with those three things implemented, in addition to our canine officer being alerted to just monitoring the traffic in the parking lots, I think we have it covered. But congratulations to the students that got back into school today. Wish them well. Thank you.
Thank you, Chief. Mr. Dursick.
Yes, I just want to reiterate that the smoke testing started today on Aurora Road east of Highland, including Portage, Yaga, and Edith. They should probably be wrapping that up tomorrow, which all relates to the flooding that we've been having down Pettibone and on South Roundhead. So we are continuing to work and investigate the issues, and hopefully we can come to some solution here shortly.
Thank you. Mr. Gibbs?
No comments, thank you.
Okay, I think I got everybody. Okay, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
Make a motion to adjourn.
Okay, motion by Mr. Russo, seconded by Mr. Schimmitz. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Kalunas?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Schimmitz?
Yes.
Mr. Zellwin?
Yes.
Okay, good night, everyone.